Are you saying that the application would be two separate projects as we're splitting them up?
Absolutely.
And let the voters decide.
Absolutely. We have a motion on the table, we have a second, and we have further discussion on this.
Yeah, just a little bit, I personally would like to thank the wind committee. They've worked a long time, very hard, and I imagine they didn't agree on every issue when they were going through it. And we sent them back and had them work on it some more, and they actually voted 5-0 for their recommendation to have two wind turbines at the two separate locations. Also want to wish Abigail, I'm sorry to see Abigail leaving, moving out of town type of stuff, it's too bad. But anyway, I do think it's important that we chose these people because of their expertise. And I don't think we would be harmed if we went forward with the two applications and separate projects. I do believe it would be an advantage to do it as two projects at the same time, as Bucky has already mentioned a number of times. I recognize that there is some concern about the aesthetic values of wind turbines in two different locations, in those locations. But at the same time, I think it's important that as a town, that we state, as we did with our opposition to LNG, our support of alternative and renewable wind power, renewable power source. So I would encourage everyone to aye on this motion.
Which one?
The one, your motion.
The only motion on the table.
Still, we're discussing.
Yeah.
Let's do a motion.
Yeah, we're tomorrow. Bill?
I think I agree with Mike. I'm not ready to go forward with Fort Getty for several reasons, one of which is I'm still looking at the cumulative debt burden that we would be taking on with two wind turbines. To me, that's significant, and I'm a little nervous about that much debt. Should we come up short? And also, I'm also concerned about trying to get it past the voters, but that's a very large bond to be asking for. I'm hoping we do it at the November election. And my logic between the two, Taylor Point's Skyview was already somewhat effective or negatively, however you want to talk about it, the Newport Bridge there. So it's not an unspoiled view from certain angles, whereas at Fort Getty it is. There's nothing in the Skyview down that direction. So I'm not in favor of moving forward with the second one. And I think the first one's a good one to start with and see if we can get it accomplished.
You know, as I stated that night, I think that's my position, is that not so much that Fort Getty's an unsuitable site, it's certainly a suitable site. I think that we need to wait a little longer before going forward with at Fort Getty. And I think that there's plenty of opportunity to do it later on. I'm not feeling that there's any need to rush into doing two at once. Putting two up at the same time, we do have some resistance to putting turbines up on the island, as you saw in the James Bond press this past week. I think going at trying to do two might be a little bit much at this time. I'd like this to go forward with one. We're already proving Taylor Point. I'd like to hold off on going forward with one in Fort Getty. So.
Don, thank you. Don Library, 354 Peterbilt Road, also on the Wind Committee. By saying no tonight, I would encourage you to vote in favor of the motion that's on the table. By saying no tonight, you deprive the voters of Jamestown of the right to say where they want the turbines and how many. The only decision that's really essential for you to make tonight is what grants to apply for. I've heard a lot of discussion about let the people decide. Well, you're deciding for the people by voting no and voting against this motion. You're also voting for a multi-million dollar tax increase for Jamestown, because all of the models, you look skeptical, Bill, all of these models show these turbines are profitable. All of the experience in Jamestown with, has built turbines in Jamestown, in Rhode Island, with these turbines show they're profitable. We have a guaranteed rate of payment from National Grid under the net metering law that guarantees the revenue. So really the only risk here is that electricity prices would start steeply decline, or well, that's really the only one. And if you really think that electricity prices are going to steeply decline, then you shouldn't build any turbines. But if the wind blows, these turbines will, and electricity remains at its current rates or increases, these turbines will generate millions of extra profit for the town. And I urge you to consider that in your vote and let the people decide.
I can address that.
I'm not going to take any more discussion from...
Just one question.
I can address that.
Going to take any more discussion from the audience at this point. We had a fairly lengthy discussion at the last meeting, and I think we've gone through it all. The only points that were left over was really the modeling, and that's what is before us tonight. So I'm not going to open it up, unfortunately, at this point.
So I'm not against Fort Getty. I'm against Fort Getty this right now, and I think we can do it at a later time, and we still, if we decide at a later time to do it, will still make money for the town. So
extra cost installation.
Yes, right. But we may be able to go in with renting a barge, doing transportation issues with other towns who are a little bit further behind us. That's part of the discussion we've had with Washington County. They're on board with doing turbines. There's a lot of option to piggyback with some of them and maybe get some deals with buying turbines 3, 5, or more at a time and save some money. I don't think it's a catastrophic decision. And I don't think the town is going to lose the out millions of dollars based upon where we're going with this, because it will come up again as part of Fort Getty. And I think we owe it to the town also to decide what we're going to do with Fort Getty. So that's what we're proposing now, is to do it. Bring it up again later.
Okay, we have a motion.
So what if we apply for one stimulus fund for one turbine and it gets rejected? If we apply for two and say arbitrarily for some reason whoever makes the decision decided to go for one but not two, or do you know what I'm saying? I think we're precluding our options. It is just going for money, period. It's all it is at this point. It does not, I feel we're kind of tying Jamestown's hands here, and we're going into micromanaging wind turbine size and all sorts of details. I don't think that's relevant at the moment. I think it's going for two $750,000 opportunities for Jamestown and not making the decision ahead of time.
All right, we have a motion on the table. It has been seconded for a Fort Getty wind turbine and to apply for federal funding of $750,000, Rhode Island EDC, $500,000, credits, and municipal bonds to balance. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
No.
Aye.
Motion
failed. We didn't talk about this, right?
Excuse me?
Did you talk at all about it?
Excuse me? I don't think that's really appropriate to
me. I find it funny also that here we went, the first motion was...
Moving on in business.
First motion was to go for two turbines, and then all of a sudden we have a two...
Sorry, the next unfinished business, Fort Getty Master Plan.